we've been told that aging is a natural part of life, but what if we didn't actually have to grow older? What if you could go back in time to an age where you were faster, sharper, and more vivacious than you are now? Many scientists believe that aging isn't a necessary part of life, and have been making huge breakthroughs in the quest to cure it and the many problems that come along with it. By 2050, the world's population of people 60 years and older is expected to double, increasing from a little over 1 billion to 2.1 billion. While there has been an increase in life expectancy, many people are living longer in poor health. Aging is a process that happens to everyone over time. It is caused by damage at the cellular and molecular level, which can lead to a decline in physical and mental abilities and an increased risk of diseases such as cancer, heart disease, Alzheimer's, type 2 diabetes, arthritis, and lung disease. Aging is the biggest risk factor for these and many other major illnesses. Who wants to live longer if it means being bedridden or needing assistance? But it might not have to be this way much longer. Investors are putting a lot of money into research to try and understand the biology of aging and how to optimize it for longer life. Companies such as Calico Life Sciences, funded by Google, and many individuals, including tech executives and crypto millionaires, have invested billions into the field. There is a lot of potential for profit in finding a way to extend human lifespan, and many people with money to spare are betting on this research being the next big thing. Researchers at the Bobberham Institute, led by Professor Reich, have already found a way to make human skin cells act younger by time-jumping them by 3 decades. This method is more effective at reversing the aging process in cells than previous techniques, and the cells still work properly after being treated. The team conducted experiments on skin cells that simulated a wound and found that the partially rejuvenated cells behaved more like younger cells. While the research is still in its early stages, experts believe it could lead to significant advancements in regenerative medicine. The researchers found that their method not only reversed the aging process in cells, but also had an impact on other genes that are linked to Alzheimer's disease and the development of cataracts. Many scientists believe that if we can reverse the aging process, it will be possible to prevent age-related diseases altogether, such as cancer, heart disease, and Alzheimer's. With current technology, it may be possible to live into old age without worrying about developing these diseases. Microbiologist David Sinclair said in an interview with CNN in 2022, "This is the world that is coming. It's literally a question of when, and for most of us, it's going to happen in our lifetimes." Researchers use artificial intelligence, large amounts of data, and techniques like cellular reprogramming to study and understand the molecular processes that keep our bodies functioning. Some of these modern-day age-reversing breakthroughs have been in the works for decades. In 2006, Shinya Yamanaka, a Japanese stem cell researcher, discovered how to reprogram adult cells and turn them into an embryonic-like state through a process called cellular reprogramming. This breakthrough in cell biology revolutionized the field, and it earned Yamanaka a Nobel Prize. Juan Carlos Ispizua Belmonte, a biologist researching organ regeneration, later explored the possibility of using Yamanaka's method to partially reverse aging by restoring the youthful resilience of cells while still maintaining their function and identity. While it will likely be years before age-reversing treatments will be widely available to the public, the good news is that scientists have already been making mice live much longer. David Sinclair and his team at Harvard Medical School have used proteins to turn adult cells into stem cells and revert aging cells in mice to an earlier stage. In a study published in late 2020, they found that old mice with poor eyesight and damaged retinas were able to see again, with vision that was sometimes even better than that of younger mice. Rapamycin, a drug commonly used to prevent organ rejection after a transplant, has been found to increase the lifespan of middle-aged mice by up to 60%. Other drugs called senolytics can help elderly mice stay healthy for longer periods of time. There are also several other interventions, such as the diabetes drugs metformin and acarbose, calorie restriction, and other methods that have been shown to extend the lifespan of mice in lab studies. If the experiments on mice can lead to the development of drugs or therapies that can clean up the molecular and biochemical damage that causes many health problems in old age, it may be possible for more people to reach their mid-80s or 90s without suffering from age-related problems and ailments. It may also be possible for more people to reach the maximum human lifespan, which is currently believed to be between 120 and 125 years. In industrialized countries, only about 1 in 6,000 people live to be 100, and only 1 in 5 million people live past 110. The oldest recorded person was Jeanne Calment, who lived in France and died in 1997 at the age of 122 years and 164 days. Some researchers believe that humans may be able to live for 1,000 years or more in the future. Aging is a process that occurs over time, as our cells change and undergo mutations in their DNA, stop dividing, and accumulate harmful waste products. During the aging process, protective caps on chromosomes called telomeres shorten. The genome becomes unstable and prone to DNA mutations that can cause cancer, and changes occur in the epigenome, which are compounds that regulate gene activity. Some cells become senescent, meaning they stop functioning properly but do not die, and instead release chemicals that cause inflammation. There are also disruptions in pathways that respond to nutrients, lipids, and cholesterol, which can affect metabolism. There's still a lot of uncertainty about how these changes interact with each other and which are the most important to address in order to understand and potentially modify the aging process. Humans have chased dreams of eternal youth for centuries, but the study of aging hasn't been properly funded or really taken seriously until recently in the last couple decades. Cynthia Kenyon had trouble recruiting young researchers to assist her in the experiments that would revolutionize the field. While working at the University of California, San Francisco, she altered a gene in roundworms known as C. elegans and doubled their lifespan. The altered worms acted much younger when examined under the microscope, while the unaltered worms were sluggish and old. Kenyon's research showed that aging is influenced by genes, cellular pathways, and biochemical signals, and is therefore malleable and can potentially be modified. While research on animals such as worms and mice may work in delaying the onset of aging, that doesn't mean that it'll work as well in humans. Senolytics, which are drugs that target and kill cells that accumulate with age, were initially thought to have potential as an anti-aging therapy, but clinical trials have not yet shown many significant benefits. Researchers and biotech companies are continuing to study senolytics and other anti-aging compounds in clinical trials to treat various conditions, including Alzheimer's, long COVID, chronic kidney disease, frailty in cancer survivors, and a complication of diabetes that can cause blindness. However, none of the experimental drugs that have shown promising results in mice have yet been approved for use in humans. Even with the hope for a treatment that extends life and reverses aging, there are simple things that we can do every day to increase our lives. Researchers at the Harvard T.H. Chan School of Public Health looked at decades of data from 123,000 adults in the U.S., and they found that 5 habits may increase life expectancy by 14 years in women and 12 years in men. Those were good diet, regular exercise, healthy weight, not smoking, and not drinking too much. Thanks for watching. Make sure you like this video, and if you would like to see more videos like this, make sure to subscribe. We'll see you next time here on Mythical Modern.